you how I got this purplish, fuchsia-ish, ombre-ish. I obviously do not know what I'm calling it, but basically I'm just gonna be showing you how I got this hair color. I don't know if I have to complicate things. I used a new product. I used this Lime Crime unicorn hair, gave it a try. At the end of the tutorial, I'm gonna do a little review on this. So if you wanna see how I got this purple ombre-ish thing, I don't even, is that what we're gonna call it? Whatever. If you guys wanna see how I got this hair color, then just keep watching.
All right, so before we start painting on our hair, we're gonna need a couple things. First things first, we're gonna need some gloves because this color legit stains everything. So you're also gonna need a crappy t-shirt, or you can do this naked, I won't judge you. For the dark purple shade we'll be placing on our roots, you're gonna need a plastic bowl, a brush, and of course the unicorn hair dye in the shade Pony. You're gonna put about half of this jar in the bowl, or at least I did, just depends on how much you're gonna use, and that's it. For the second hair color, we're gonna be putting this in the mid-shaft area of the hair. You're gonna need the plastic bowl, the brush, per usual. But we're gonna be mixing the unicorn hair dye with conditioner to kind of dilute it and make it the medium purplish fuchsia shade. So what I do is I just put some of the purple shade in the bowl and then put conditioner in it, and then mix it all together. Also, to avoid staining my countertops purple, I went ahead and put a towel down just because I know I'm the clumsiest person alive. All right, now for the fun part. This hair color does have to be placed over blonde hair in order to show up. It could be naturally blonde hair or bleached hair. Mine is personally bleached, obviously. So I went ahead and bleached my roots before I did this. To start sectioning off the hair, I'm going to part it straight down the middle like you're doing pigtails. I'm gonna apply that root color all the way down that part to hold it in place. Then I'm gonna part it from the top of the head to the top of the ear, and again, place that root color all the way down that part on either side. Dividing your hair into sections like this definitely helps so you don't miss any spots. So I did the same thing on the other side, just top of the head to the top of the ear, and made sure I applied that color on the root area. So from here, you should have four sections, two in the back and two in the front. I'm gonna start in the front just so you guys can see. I take the end of the brush and I just slide it across my hair diagonally and create a part. I work in really small sections, which does take longer, but I find that it does prevent any patchiness or weird inconsistencies that you can get, especially when you're using a color for the first time. So just to walk you through it again, I go ahead and part the hair off diagonally. Then I apply the color at the base using the brush. Then I'll take my fingers here and really work the color into the root area and also start dragging it out. Obviously, you don't want to drag it too far out if your hair is really short. You want to keep it closer to the root. But if you have longer hair, you can really drag out the darker root color as long as you want. Just make sure you're mapping it out since it is an ombre. So you want to make sure you still have room for your medium color and your lightest shade. But for now, I'm just going to finish the root area of this section. I'm gonna do the exact same thing on the next front section area. Just applying the darker shade to the root area and then blending it kind of down with my fingers. Now that the root area is done in the front two sections, I'm gonna take that hair color number two where we use the conditioner, and I'm gonna start working this into the middle section. I'm using bigger parts here because I'm gonna be using way more color. What I do is I just dip my hand straight into the color and start working it into that dark purple shade first, as you can see here, and then I just start dragging it down and working it into the middle section. If it looks like I'm using a ton of product here, it is because I am. I use a ton of product because I want to make sure I'm completely saturating the hair. There's nothing worse than spending all this time on your hair and then getting a splotchy hot mess. Also, I feel like gloves make it way easier to get the color into the hair, where sometimes brushes will just apply to the surface but not really get into the hair, if that makes sense. So it ends up kind of looking splotchy. Also, instead of leaving my ends just dry, I end up taking conditioner, not mixed with any color, just a plain conditioner, and working it into the ends of the hair. And that ended up giving it more of a smooth transition when doing the ombre shade. So from here, I'm just gonna work on the back two sections, just applying the darker shade to my root area, then working the second color into the midsection and the conditioner into the ends. I just wanted to show the whole process here, even though you're not gonna see a whole lot since I'm working on the back. But just in case the first two sections went by super fast, you can see how I did the rest. I wanted to mention really quick that when I am working on the back sections of my hair, I do work in a little bit more of that dark purple shade into the root area, just because those sections are really easy to miss since you really can't see them. So I basically just double saturate everything. When in doubt, just keep adding color. So once you're done painting your head, you just let it sit on for 1 whole hour and you're done.
This is basically how my hair turned out after I washed it, shampoo, condition, all that stuff. Also, just a little tip in case you don't do it already. I never let the water get super hot when I'm rinsing out my hair color, just because it can open the cuticle up and fade the hair or let go of some of that color, so it won't be as consistent or pretty looking. To the product, used Lime Crime Unicorn Hair, as you saw in the tutorial in the shade Pony. I will say I really was impressed by this product, especially since it is a non-professional brand, meaning anybody can get it. I will say that this is one of the better non-professional brands I've used. You can see how consistent the hair color is. There is no splotches or weird uneven tones. It's pretty consistent all the way through. I do really take my time when I'm working the product into the hair, but that doesn't always mean the product is going to evenly saturate the hair. I also felt like it was super easy to use. Love that, especially for non-professional products, because you've never done hair color before, you can totally use it and it's pretty user-friendly, I think. One of the big questions I always get is how this kind of stuff makes your hair feel, if it damages your hair or makes it look dry. I have experienced some of that with other brands before. I don't know if it's something I did or if it was actually just the brand of hair dye, but I have had dyes before kind of leave my hair looking just dull. Like, it didn't break off or damage my hair necessarily, it just didn't look shiny. But this did not leave my hair feeling dry or looking dry or weird or anything like that. Also, kind of off topic, it's supposed to have a cotton candy scent, which I was a little skeptical about because it's not my favorite. But it does smell really good, and I thoroughly enjoyed the scent as I was applying it to my hair. So there's that if you even care about scented things. One thing that I will say that I'm impressed with is when I got this in the mail, they actually sent it to me. This was not a sponsored video, but they did send me product. I was a little confused because you can see in comparison to my hand, this is a pretty small bottle. There is 6.76 ounces in this. To be 100% honest with you, I was like, there is no way in hell this is covering my whole head. I have a lot of hair. It is not very thick, but it's long and I have a lot of it. But the reason why I was so impressed is there's still color in this. So I didn't even use all of the color in this little container. So I will say I was really impressed that you do get a lot out of this little package. So big things come in small packages, I guess, for sure. I don't know why I even said that. I haven't tried any of the other colors, obviously, but Pony gets a 10 out of 10 or a 5 out of 5 or whatever you want to rate it. From me, especially for a non-professional color, this rules. Anyways, I think that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial slash review on this purple-ish, ombre-ish hair color. I guess that's just what we're gonna call it now. If you guys did enjoy this, you can give it a thumbs up. Say, hey girl, hey, down in the comments box, because you know I love talking to you. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!